Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, to be accompanied to the ring by the greatest promoter on the face of the earth, Colonel Robert Parker, along with Meng. Ladies and gentlemen, from Bucksthorpe, Tennessee, weighing 261 pounds, Bunkhouse Buck! Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent on Super Brawl 5, he's from Glens Falls, New York. He weighs 287 pounds, Hacksaw Jim Duggan!
The blue-collar champion, there's no question about it. They love him in Baltimore, Hacksaw Jim Duggan! Making his way to the ring. He always has a good time, you know that brain?
Yeah, a good time to him is waving that flag, shaking his 2x4, and having the humanoids yell, USA, the man, as far as I'm concerned, like you say, he's a blue-collar champion. The guy's a loser. The guy is a loser. He's a dirt-nailed loser.
Duggan still got old glory in his left hand while slugging away in his right. Duggan, the former United States heavyweight champion, lost the belt at our last pay-per-view to Vader. And of course, that solidified Vader as the number one contender, and he has that big shot coming up later on against Hogan. And first now.
Would you talk about a blue-collar champion, a guy like Duggan, you don't think that Bunkhouse Buck is one tough customer.
Oh,
this is going to be one great fight, not a mess. One great fight.
There's no question about it. You've got two heavy hitters here in this bout here on the Super Brawl telecast from Baltimore. And now, as you said, Brain, it's going to be a fight. And immediately,
Bunkhouse will take it to him.
Bunkhouse biting Duggan on the bridge of the nose early. Hip toss from the near side ropes. Duggan. He nailed him with a big clothesline. And Buck now sprawled out on the apron here on the near side here.
That's okay. He's got the Colonel with him. He's got Ming, and he's got his faculties. He is going to come out of this and watch what he's going to do to Duggan. Believe me, watch what he's going to do to Duggan.
Much like Alex Wright had earlier. Down on the floor. Much like Alex Wright earlier, there is Parker and there is the lethal bodyguard Ming, and that certainly gives an unfair advantage to Buck. But that is not stopping Duggan. We've got a brawl going on the floor here now, and side headlock sends Duggan to the ring post. He glanced it.
I'll tell you, this Bunkhouse wants to fight, and he likes it when he can fight. USA!
Reverse chin lock. A lot of hair tugging, a lot of gouging and biting.
Come on, ref. Break the hold. He pulled the hair. But no, he's not going to do it. Why? Because everybody loves Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Duggan.
Duggan. Whatever.
Between the shoulder blades, Duggan now with a headbutt. See what he has done to that top. A Bunkhouse Buck. Duggan.
That's okay. He's got 25 of them in the closet, maybe.
Oh, he does?
That may be his cleanest dirty shirt he's got right there. But he is one tough customer, believe me.
Holding on to the leg, wheeling him around, picking him up, and dropping Buckhouse Buck with an atomic drop. And that hurt all the way to Bucksnort. Big heavy right hand. He covers it. One. Foot is on the rope. It's our second bout at Super Brawl 5 from Baltimore.
You know, Tony, you talk about Super Brawl. This has been, in two matches, nothing but a Super Brawl.
Well, we anticipated a brawl between these two men because they are brawlers. Alex Wright coming.
Jam-packed,
you're right. Coming from behind in the opening bout to defeat pretty Paul Roma with Orndorff at ringside.
Elbow. Come on, Buck. Come on.
One, two. Boy, you're doing a lot of cheerleading here this evening.
Well, I can't help it. I'm a fan. You can't do what I do without being a fan. You can't get involved without caring. I care about the decent people in this sport.
Do
the
you?
The Bunkhouse Buck.
Oh, yeah, okay.
The Ric Flair. You understand.
You run in those circles, I guess you would.
And Tony, you're different. You run different circles. You like Mr. Rogers and Julia Childs.
Buck, I believe, has a rope.
Oh,
he got it right in the throat with it.
Good move.
That's what you call a decent person?
No, I call that a good move. Oh.
Throwing him through the ropes now to the floor.
He cut the rail in the short ribs.
And that Buck noticed that, and that's what he is focusing on now, stomping and hammering on the ribs of Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Colonel Parker has the attention of the referee. Duggan just trying to walk away.
It's so hard to beat Duggan. He is such a tough man.
Right in the lap of the ladies there. That's a little bit too close for them. Our ladies who are ring attendants here tonight, I guess they didn't expect to get that close to the action, but notice how Buck now chased
if they don't like that action, they should be home cooking or doing laundry.
Can I finish here?
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
After chasing him three,
where
are you ever? Chasing him three quarters around the ring, made sure he was back in the ring with a sleeper hold. There you go. Welcome to WCW, ladies. Elbow to the gut. And using the hair to help him down. And he shielded it quite well from Nick Patrick.
See her wink at me?
She winked at you?
She winked at me.
She did not.
She wink at you? She winked at me. That happens all the time. I understand that.
Up on the top rope.
Come on, Buckhouse. Watch him. Watch him.
Hard to watch him when he's underneath of you, hammering away at your gut.
Ooh.
Or maybe it's not hard to watch him. It's not hard. Oh, he. That time, Buck returned fire, and it was with plenty of impact.
Well, he got one right in the schnoz.
And these two men are going at it. They are pounding away into Donnybrook. Like you said, Crane, it's going to be a brawl at Super Brawl, and that's what it is. Duggan has broken loose now.
He snapped. That's what's happened. He has snapped.
It is a fight at Super Brawl between Bunkhouse Buck and Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And you are watching it live. The whip. The pickup, back body drop. Duggan will cover him after that. And Buckhouse Buck. Boy, that shot.
Look at
that,
Parker, he's beside himself.
That shot the hat right off his head there, didn't it? He thought it was over, and so did I. But no, the perseverance of Bunkhouse Buck. And yes, he's a brawler. Yes, he's a good old farm country boy from Tennessee. But he is a fine competitor in the ring as well.
Come on, Buckhouse, do something. Listen to the colonel. There you go. He doesn't care if his shirt's ripped. He wants to fight. He likes it like this.
Into a front face lock now.
Why'd you get off my ass?
Mow him.
Knee to the solar plexus that time. And that one was right to the chin. But that helped stand Duggan upright. A rake down the back didn't bother him at all. He's getting his second win here. But that, he caught him with the right hand and stopped Buck. Buck and Duggan. Right hand, down goes Bunkhouse Buck. big elbow drop. Two.
Has he got him? Has he got him?
One, two. No, sir. He got a two only.
See how tough Bunkhouse Buck is?
Yeah, and you saw the shake of the head that time from Hacksaw Jim Duggan. He's not so sure what it takes to keep Bunkhouse Buck down.
Well, he's not too sure about a lot of things. The guy's not a real smart guy.
Ming around Colonel Rob Parker all the time. Of course, our fans probably won't forget it wasn't too long ago, and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes was back in August, took a chair over the head of Ming and didn't even faze him. Ming truly a real tough guy. And
there's nobody tougher than Dusty Rhodes.
That's right.
He hits you with a chair, you don't respond to that. You gotta be superhuman.
Forearm shot, and that put Buck on the apron.
Come on, Buckhouse, get up.
Watch yourself.
Take this blue collar man down.
You watch yourself.
There you see Ming shielding Colonel Rob Parker as Hacksaw Jim Duggan got in Parker's face there momentarily. A pickup. This may be the beginning of his move. Here it is. He likes to spin him around, get that equilibrium to where they're not so sure he can't get up off the mat. He's going to end down. A knee drop to it and a cover. One.
He's got him.
Two.
No,
and
no.
House Buck kicks out again.
What a tough guy. This isn't a match, Shivani. This is a fight. This is Super Brawl.
Neck by supply now by Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Boy, that's not going to hurt Bunkhouse. That is not going to hurt him. It may turn his head around a little bit. He may be looking down at the back of his pockets. He will come out of this because he has the Colonel. He has Ming. He knows what he has to do. Boy, this looks like Saturday night. You drop in, don't it?
Blew him over that time. It only took his breath to send him down. And Duggan, well, he's in the ropes. And that time, Duggan wasted a little bit too much time trying the lateral press.
Well, Doug is a tough guy, but he was never known to be bright.
Oh, he grabbed at Colonel Parker.
Oh, Ming's going to eat him up, believe me.
He grabbed at Colonel Rob Parker, and you're right.
You never touch the Colonel.
You don't want to do that when Ming's around. You count to 10 along with Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Duggan can't count to 10, you know that.
He didn't have to, the fans were counting for him, Breen.
Well, they can barely count to 10.
Shoulder, firmly into the gut, make it a pair.
This takes a lot out of you. This just takes your win completely out of you.
Yeah, being in this match takes a lot out of you. These two men have, it has been, lack of a better term, a brutal matchup. It's been a high impact. It's been exactly what we thought it would be.
And look at the physique on Duggan. This guy is really in shape. Too bad he doesn't have anything going from the ears up.
What do you mean? He's got plenty of hair on his head.
Talking about brain matter.
The hammerlock driving the knee in. Duggan, he's going to rip that shirt a little bit more. First time we've seen old Bunkhouse Buck without his shirt on. And Duggan and Buck still going at it. Suspenders are down. The big pickup and a slam from Duggan.
It doesn't matter if his shirt's off, if the suspenders are off. This man knows how to fight.
Break to the eyes. Colonel Parker. Parker with a punch. And he nailed Colonel Parker.
Parker's out.
3-point stance. One, two, three. Duggan wins it.
Oh, what's this?
Ming
what's
is this? In.
Oh my goodness. Do it. Ming, take his hair off. Take the beard right off his face.
And he's doing it. He's planted a nerve hold on Duggan, and Duggan's already out from that savate kick.
That's the old rule.
In retaliation.
You mess with the Colonel.
That's right. In retaliation, apparently, for what happened to Colonel Parker, Duggan wins the match, but he is being brutalized by the bodyguard now. And this guy has no business in the ring at all. He He's a bodyguard. He will not let go of Duggan. Another referee is in.
He is the toughest man walking the face of the earth. You watch this. Watch it closely.
All right, we need to go to Gary Capetta for the official verdict on this match.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Well, Duggan may have won the match, but he is out. All right, let's take a look once again, Brain, exactly how all this transpired in this hard-hitting matchup that ended, unfortunately, for Duggan, well, with a win, but then with Ming. Here you go, Brain.
And you're right, you're talking about a hard-hitting match. There, Duggan, Chief shots the Colonel. The Colonel goes down. You do not touch the Colonel. Everybody knows that. Duggan thinks he gets the win here. Chief, 1-2-3.
Well, he got the 1-2-3, but of course, then it was Ming with the Sabat kick. Right in the face. And then the nerve hold.
Well, I'll tell you something. Ming is such a devastating human being. Nobody is going to get by this man, Ming.
Well, Brain, you're right. Ming is devastating. There's no question about it. But I must stress that Ming is a bodyguard assigned to Colonel Rob Parker. And even though there was contact with Colonel Rob Parker, Ming had no business getting in the ring. I'm glad to see some.
Well, Duggan had no business touching the Colonel.
Well, what was he doing up on the apron of the ring?
He's not in the ring. He's on the apron. He's not in the ring. He's on the apron. You understand that?
You're repeating yourself.
I'm telling you exactly how it is, so you understand, Mr. Schiavone.
Schiavone it is.
Doesn't matter.
Fans, standing by, of course.
He was on the apron. He was not in the ring. He was on the apron, not in the ring. You know that.
Nick Bockwinkel, commissioner of WCW, is here, and hopefully he has seen exactly what has happened. And I would think there'd be some money coming out of the pocket of either Ming or Colonel Rob Parker. Right now, as we said, back in the locker room area, let's go to Mean Gene
Oakland. He was on the apron. He wasn't in the ring. You understand that?